Welcome to the React Maps tutorial. In this video, I will show you how to add and customize markers in the Syncfusion React Maps component. Look at this example. A world map is displayed with markers that provide information about the top 15 cities by population. These markers are differentiated by colors, shapes, and custom sizes. Let's start by adding code to show and customize markers in React Maps. First, I'll open an existing application where I have already added the React Maps component with basic properties. I have included a GeoJSON shape of the world map in the maps layer. I have also applied custom fill color to the map elements. To learn more about integrating the maps component into a React application, please check the Getting Started video linked in the card above and the description below. Let me run this application using the npm start command to show the initial output. Here, the map is rendered based on the GeoJSON data. Let's see the steps to show markers in the map elements. First, I import the marker and inject modules from the J2 React Maps package and inject marker module into the services. Then, I add the MarkersDirective tag, which accepts send number of MarkerDirective tags. For this example, I will add a single MarkerDirective tag. Inside this tag, I enable the visible property to show the markers. Next, I need to populate the data source to add markers. I'm going to represent cities with the highest number of population using the markers. So, let me define an array marker data with the name, latitude, longitude, population, color, and shape fields. By default, the maps component displays markers based on the latitudes and longitudes in the given data source. So, the data source must contain these fields. In a few minutes in the video, I'll demonstrate how to use the color and shape fields from the data source to set custom colors and shapes for the marker. I will also show you how to utilize the population field while showing tooltips. I assign this data to the data source property of the MarkerDirective tag, as markers will be added based on the latitude and longitude data source fields. No additional mapping is required. I add the title settings property and set the title as top 15 populated cities in the world using the text property. You can see the React Maps component rendering the world map with markers representing the top 15 cities by population. Now I will demonstrate how to change the shape of the markers. By default, the marker's shape is set to balloon. However, markers also support other shapes such as circles, crosses, diamonds, and more. To change the default shape to a circle, add the shape property in the MarkerDirective tag and set the type to circle. Now, the marker shape is changed to circle. You can also assign the shape to each marker based on the data source. Add the shape value path property and assign the shape data source field. I then comment out this shape property. Now, the markers with shapes like diamonds, pentagons, rectangles, and inverted triangles are added. Next, to customize markers, use properties such as border, dash array, fill, opacity, animation delay, animation duration, and more. If you want to apply a custom color, add the fill property and set it to white. To customize the marker border, add the border property and set the width to 2, and the color to steel blue. Now, markers are customized with fill and border colors. Next, I'll show you how to set colors for the markers from the data source. I've already added the color field with an appropriate value to this data source. So, I'll assign this color field to the color value path property to set colors. Since I have referred to the color from the data source, I'll comment out the fill property. When you look at the map elements, you'll notice different colored markers based on the data source field. Next, let me show you how to render markers with images. First, I comment out the shape value path, color value path, and border properties for clarity, and set the shape property to image. Then I include the image URL property, set the Syncfusion demo image URL, and set custom height and width to show the image. Look, a custom image is shown for each marker. Next, I'll show you how to display tooltips when hovering over the markers. First, import the Maps tooltip module from the J2 React Maps package and inject it into the services. Then, inside the MarkersDirective tag, I add the tooltip settings property and enable the visible property. I also set the value path property to the population data source field name to show population counts on the tooltips. I enable the use grouping separator property to separate the numeric text with a comma separator. I also set the format property to n. See, tooltips are shown for every marker on the map. Finally, I will show you how to format marker tooltips. I plan to display the city name and population count in the tooltip. So I add the format property and set the name field to display the city name. Then I included the break tag to insert a line break and incorporated the population field to show the population count. Look at the map now. The tooltip shows the city's name and population count for every data point. In this video, I have shown you how to add markers to the React Maps component, change the marker type, customize the markers, add tooltips, and format them. If you want to try out the example used in this video, you can download it from the GitHub link in the description below. I have also shared a link to learn about obtaining a free license key to use our React suite through our community license, if you are eligible. Thank you for watching this video. If you found it helpful, please like and subscribe to our channel.